president, when I'm president, it's going to be very clear that we finally have an administration and a president and a government in the United States that actually likes job creators, that wants to help job creators. And this is very personal, and I know there are many stories that can be told right here with you, but I was in Richmond, Virginia 2 days ago, and I met a woman there named Rhoda Elliott. She's been managing the family restaurants for a number of years. Bill's Barbecue has been in her family for 82 years, and she closed it down. She said that all the regulations, all the taxation, the cost of Obamacare, and the cost of the Obama economy made it such that after 82 years, they just couldn't keep on going. And this was not a matter of money for her. This was a matter of a future for her family and a future for the families of those who worked in her enterprise. I want to help Rhoda. I want to help small business people across the country, and I will. We'll get it done. You know, I've watched over the last few months as our campaign has gone from a start to a movement. It's not just the size of the crowds. It's the conviction and compassion in the hearts of the people. It's made me strive to be more worthy of the support that I've received across the country and to campaign as I would govern to speak for the aspirations of all Americans, not just some Americans. I learned as governor of Massachusetts that the best achievements and accomplishments are shared achievements. I learned that respect and goodwill goes a long way, and it's likely to be reciprocated. That's how I conduct myself as president. I won't represent just one party. I'll represent one nation. Yesterday, the president said something you may have heard by now that I think surprised a lot of people. Speaking to an audience, he said, you know, voting is the best revenge. He told his supporters, voting for revenge. Vote for revenge? Let me tell you what I'd like to tell you. Vote for love of country. It is time we lead America to a better place. Now, if there's anybody there who's worried about the last 4 years and wondered if they're the best we can do, who fears that the American dream is fading away, if anyone wonders whether good jobs and better take-home pay are out there, I've got a clear and unequivocal message for you, and that is America is about to come roaring back. And you saw the differences. You saw the differences between Barack Obama and me in those debates. I like those debates, I gotta be honest. I mean, he says it has to be this way. I say it can't stay this way. He's offering excuses, I'm offering a plan. I can't wait to get started. He wants to convince you to settle. But Americans don't settle. We dream, we aspire. We reach for greater things, and we will achieve greater things with new leadership. On November 6th, we're coming together for a better future. And on November 7th, we're going to get started. And by the way, what I need you to do is to go across your street to your neighbor that has that other sign in the front yard. And in Washington, I'm going to go across the aisle to the guys who have been working for the other candidate. We're going to come together. This is a critical time for the nation. We face such huge challenges. So many people out of work, take-home pay declining, home values bumping along the bottom. Then even around the world, tougher competition from nations like China, potential threats from a nuclear Iran that's on a pathway to become nuclear, that is. We face extraordinary challenges. This is time for us to come together as a people. We've journeyed far and wide in this great campaign. We've had some long days and some very short nights, but we are almost there. And the door to opportunity, it is open, and we're going to walk through it. Come walk with me. Walk together to a better place. We have got to take back this country. We have got to restore the greatness that is America. We come from a nation of great people. I love the American people. I believe in America. I believe in you. I see a gentleman here, U.S. Navy retired. I see members of our armed forces, U.S. Army here, veteran, U.S. Army retired. I appreciate those who have sacrificed for our greatness, for our future, for our freedom. This is a nation that lives for things bigger than ourselves. We have full hearts in this nation. I've been, Ann and I had the fun some years ago of watching a show on TV with a fictional football team. And before they'd go out on the field and face typically higher ranked team than themselves, long odds, if you will, they had a sign on the door of their locker room, and it said, "Clear eyes, full hearts, can't lose." And as I look here, I know we have full hearts. And the people of New Hampshire, you've been around a while, you've looked at politicians, you've got clear eyes, you know how to judge what's what. I'm counting on your clear eyes and full hearts to make sure we can't lose on Tuesday. Thank you so very much. You guys are the best. Thank you. Great to be with you. Thank you. Thanks, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.